This is the SAP Developer News for September 5th, 2024.
Hey everybody, it is September, October, and that time period reminds me of a certain festival. That's right, Devtoberfest. Devtoberfest from SAP TechEd is here. We're putting it on and it starts in 2 weeks. So the first event's gonna happen September 23rd, so please register. It's easy to register, you just join the SAP group. I'll put a link to that community page. And if you're already a member of that community page group, you're already enrolled to participate in Devtoberfest this year. And you can earn points. And speaking of points, we have that four-level game board. You can reach Nerdvana, and you qualify to be in our grand prize drawing. Like years past, people have gone on trips to major theme parks around the world as part of Devtoberfest. So by earning points and learning, you actually get a prize, possibly. So go to that community page and click join. The other thing I wanted to point out is the number 5. It's the 5th year I've had a blue beard that I've been your blue bearded idiot. But hey, it's also the 5th Devtoberfest. Can you believe it? We've been doing this for developers, by developers for 5 years. But it's not just for developers, right? Anybody who wants to learn as part of the SAP community can pick a topic they're interested in, and they can just complete tutorials or attend events and watch an SAP expert present to them. So 5 days of the week, 5 different topics. Speaking of that, if you look at the calendar, in our SAP community page, you'll see Monday has green circles for ABAP and CAP. Tuesday is Tooling Tuesdays with a purple circle. That's fun to say. Wednesday, we have red circles for integration. Thursday, don't be mad, machine learning, AI, and data with a blue circle. And then we have front-end Fridays with an orange circle. So really, 2 weeks away, 4 great weeks of content, but Devtoberfest is 5 weeks long this year because we are going to stop and do SAP TechEd October 8th and 9th live from Germany. So the developer advocates, a lot of SAP experts will be doing virtual TechEd live during that week of October 8th and 9th. And then we come right back for week 3 of SAP Devtoberfest on October 14th. So please register. Let's pump up those numbers. Let's do as many tutorials as possible and see how many people can qualify for Nerdvana. Can't wait to see you online. Bye.
Hola, SAP developers. Look what I got over the mail. Yep, a sticker of CPINet. CPINet, which is an open source tool that can help you with your cloud integration governance, just turned 5 years old. Thanks, Morten, for all the great work. And well, to celebrate it, Morten just released a new version of the tool, version 1.0.5, which now supports OAuth 2.0 to communicate with your cloud integration tenant, a mechanism to import a rules file, and a new rule to check user roles. If you want to learn more about CPINet, make sure to check out the Devtoberfest session that we have scheduled for the 25th of September, where Morten will be sharing with us how to automate our SAP Cloud Integration Governance with CPINet. Hasta la vista, SAP developers.
You might have heard about SAP HANA Cloud's new capability called the Vector Engine a lot this year. You might have even participated in the developer challenge, which I organized earlier this year and where we used it as well. Now at the SAP community, you will find 2 new blog posts describing interesting cases. So one is how metadata enrichment can enhance SAP HANA Cloud Vector Engine. And the other one is how leveraging image embeddings and SAP HANA Vector Engine for reverse product search can be implemented. If you are joining the new SAP CodeGem topic that my teammate Nora announced last week on getting started with the generative AI hub in SAP AI Core, then you would use this capability as well. We have 2 of these CodeGems already announced, and they are available for you to sign up if you are in Warsaw or in Munich. Getting started with machine learning using SAP HANA was quite a popular topic for CodeGems during the first half of this year. But even now, we have already 4 more events scheduled for you. So if you are in Isernhagen or in Stuttgart in Germany, or if you are in Porto or Lisbon in Portugal, then please join me this month if you're interested in some hands-on exercises where you will be using SAP Business Application Studio, Python, and Predictive Analytics Library from SAP HANA Cloud to train some classification models. The other kind of model that are extremely popular among SAP customers are time series forecasting. And my colleagues, Andreas Foster and Yannick Schapper, published recently a blog post describing how to do that, where they're focusing on one of the most powerful time series forecasting algorithms, and they're showing how to build both single and multiple time series.
Hola, SAP developers. It is easier than ever to get started with the SAP BTP solution diagrams. Why is that, you might ask? Well, the icons are now available out of the box in Draw.io. All you have to do is click on More Shapes at the bottom of the Shapes panel in Draw.io, enable the checkbox next to the SAP Shape Library in the Networking section, and click Apply. Voila! All the icons are now available there for you to start your diagrams. I'm looking forward to seeing your architecture diagrams in SAP community. Happy diagramming!